Before you undo this, you want to make double sure that the power is off. Because this is such an old plug, I located what I thought was a circuit inside the electrical panel and I turned it off. Then I came back over here and checked it and the power was off. But I thought, you know what? I didn't check it first to make sure that there was power on there. So I'm not quite sure if that breaker shut it off or not. Maybe there's no power to this already or something like that. So I turned that breaker back on and then I tested this. Sure enough, there was power here. So I turned it back off. So I did some double checking and made sure the power was off. I checked my tester on here before and after and put that in there. Nothing's showing up. I even put a radio in there and made sure it worked that way. You don't have to have a little tester like this, okay? You just put a radio in there or put a lamp in there, a drill, you know, anything, trouble light, whatever. You want to make extra sure the power's off before you start working on a plug. That goes for any electrical, by the way. Okay, be safe, not sorry. Another thing they did is that they installed this plug upside down too, and the ground area here has been cracked off on both of those. I mean, this is just an accident ready to happen. So I'm glad, you know, if it's happened, it might as well happen on my watch so I can bring it to you, right? So all I gotta do here is undo these screws, jerk this sucker out of the wall. Okay, go ahead and unscrew that. Let's see if this is gonna come out of here. Okay. It still blows my mind that somebody would put this so close, you know? Wow, these wires look pretty old. Looks like there's two wires in there even, and one wire has been cut off. I don't know if you can see it, but there's another wire back in there. But I guess I'm not gonna have to worry about that, am I? I'm just gonna cut these wires off because I don't need to save this or anything. I still like to be careful. Man, these wires look kind of old, but that's all right. I'm just gonna cut these off. And so I can shove this back into the box when I get done. I'll just straighten out these tips. And I could probably put the wire nut on without even stripping this wire back. You know what I mean? I've done that before. I mean, if you don't have a small enough wire nut, like see, I've got a yellow wire nut. I could put that right on here and twist it on there and know that that's tight. And I can't pull that off. Now, just for temporary, that's okay. And, you know, but if I were to strip this, then the yellow wire nut might not fit on there as easily as an orange wire nut, because an orange wire nut is a lot smaller. See how much smaller it is than the yellow? And that's for small wires and stuff, and I could do that. In fact, I could almost do it like this, but you know, it's not that, like I said, it's not that big of a deal. And even for safety after that, if you want, you can go ahead and put some electrical tape around here just to keep the wire nut on if you're having any questions about it, okay? The ground wire, I don't need to put anything on that. I'm just gonna shove that into the box. Get myself another wire nut here. And like I said, don't think I'm gonna just leave it like this and cover up this box, because that is a no-no. I repeat, that is a no-no, and I'm not doing that. I don't wanna get up in the attic right now and do it. I wanna do it later. I wanna get my project finished. I'm pretty much ready to paint. to prime and paint. I can't do anything until I patch this silly little hole here. You know? Okay? There it is. I'm ready to patch that. Now let's say this happens to you and you don't want to patch this and your wall's all done and everything. You could go down to the store and you could get a blank plate like this, and it's not really going to fit just yet, is it? I mean, I guess you could make some new holes and screw it in there with some little plastic anchors or do something like that, but it's probably not going to fit very well because the sheetrock's not very strong right there and right there. So if you were going to do that, you'd have to measure this from the holes and then put a mark on here, and you could cut that off. You could do that with a hacksaw. I've done it with a hacksaw before. It takes a while, but you could do that and then put the cut end over next to the edge here, put that on there like that, screw it on. You could caulk that edge if you wanted. You could make it look nicer than how it was before if you don't need the plug there, you know? But in this case, I'm not gonna do that, am I? I'm gonna do something different. Before I patch this, let me show you what I'm gonna do up in the attic. Remember I said I was gonna cut that wire back and put it in a junction box? Well, here's the box, just a little plastic nail-on box. And I'm going to take that, and I can nail that up to next to the wall up there, or on the side of the wall, whatever, on a ceiling joist. And then I can run the wire in there, and then cap it off inside this box with some wire nuts. Kind of like I showed you before, you can put electrical tape over them too. And then you're going to put a blank plate on it like that. Okay? And that's how you can leave it up in your ceiling. You can leave it like that for pretty much ever if you wanted, or if you ever need to fish that down to a different location and add a plug somewhere, you could take the power right out of this location. If you're just going to add another plug, like a plug for a plug, you don't want to add a dedicated circuit for some high powered machinery or something and think you're going to take it off of that one plug that was in the wall, because that plug there in the wall was daisy chained and hooked up to 8 or 9 other standard electrical outlets. So you don't want to overload a circuit. But if you're adding one plug, you know, for a radio or for a lamp or for anything like that, you know, you can tap into this in the attic and come down with your new plug to a cut-in box.